Kevin Vislocky is also a passionate collector of other stuff besides airplanes. And so I thought it was kind of, well, unique and that sort of thing that he's got these C's, S-E-E, Small Engineer Excavator, that he's gotten through the surplus system. But we're going to talk about, you're also the rest of this Army Green sickness that you have. Sure. But you know, these things are unique. And these came on during my early days. The engineers got these things. Man, they put the D-ring and D-handled shovel away, and they were happy to get these things. So, but you know, in the surplus system, you know, these cost the government almost $95,000 a piece.
Yes, sir.
They were made by Mercedes-Benz. And again, most of all engineer units had these. And so tell me about this particular one, Kev, because you've got three available, but let's talk a little bit about this one.
This particular one is somewhat unique. It is also part of the excavator type chassis. Same Unimog made by Mercedes-Benz.
Right.
But this one had a forklift attachment on it, and it was designed for field use. This can be adjusted if you're in rough terrain. It can be adjusted to go over obstacles and so forth, which is unique to a forklift. But also on the back of this is very unique. It has an articulating crane system.
Okay.
And like all of these, they're designed to travel down the road approximately 55 miles per hour.
Right.
And yet when you get on location, this mechanism folds out into a normal crane type of system. And in this case, it's a three-arm crane, lifts approximately 4,000 pounds, and it's fully articulating. It was designed primarily for moving everything from cargo, ammunition boxes, and so forth. But it's very, like I said, articulate in its ability to move fairly close areas and so forth. And it was very useful for the type of operations.
Well, see, as an infantry guy, we were always jealous of the engineers because, you know, we were still stuck with a D-handled shovel. But we were always glad when these guys showed up because, again, not only did they help move some of the engineering material and some of the ammo and stuff, especially in the rear area and the support groups. But then let's walk over here and talk about the other one, which really kind of modernized engineer units in the field because, you know, back during the 80s and the height of the Cold War, it was always about digging in and it was about the Soviets and, you know, we had to have hull down positions for not only our tow weapon systems and that sort of thing. And not that it's a lot different today, but this thing came on board. Man, we could put together a position in a heartbeat from trenches for infantry guys, Humvees with tow mounts, tanks, you name it. The engineers could do it with one of these.
A very capable machine. As you know, it has a bucket on the front, just like a bulldozer.
Yeah.
Fully articulating also there. But one of the neatest things about this vehicle is it has a hydraulic system. It's all self-contained, and there's approximately 50 feet of hose on the other side that you could attach these implements. That included a chainsaw, hydraulic controlled chainsaw, auger, and also a jackhammer system. So you could break up concrete, cut down trees, on the back is a regular case manufactured backhoe.
Yep.
This is a standard case, and as you said, they would dig trenches, do encampments and so forth with this. But the biggest thing again is it was self-contained. It could get to a remote area, and just with what the tools and implements it had, it could do a lot of work, more so than individuals could.